It's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. And today we're going to talk about the term driftodontics. And I made this video just because I was surprised that most people hadn't heard of this term, and it's something we used all the time in residency. So I want to explain the concept because it's actually really, really cool. So here's the thing, is that teeth want to be straight, believe it or not. You just have to, it's like building a house. Like, if you build your house too small and you have too much stuff, it's going to be cluttered, right? It's going to be crowded. There's going to be no space. But if you build a bigger house, everything can be neat and tidy. So the cool thing, kind of a bad analogy, but cool thing about teeth is if you build the right width jaws and the right position jaws, like from left to right, from mesial to distal, from anterior to posterior, and put them in the right bite and the right width, teeth generally come in pretty darn straight. How do I know this? Well, there's tons of tribal, research, anthropological research, I can't say that word today, that shows this, that when you have the proper diet and the jaws come in, the proper genetics, both, teeth will generally come in quite straight. It may not be 99.9% straight, it might be 92% straight, but it looks pretty darn good, and you really don't need orthodontics if you have the right size jaws and the right position of jaws, which is most of the time, although there can be a small genetic relationship, it can be totally modified as long as the child is young. Easy, easy, easy to counteract genetics. Anyways, so driftodontics is cool because, for example, if the child is growing and if we widen the jaws and or grow a jaw, in general, the teeth that haven't erupted yet just come right into place. Pretty cool, right? It's like free orthodontics, kind of. I mean, you don't even have to always do braces or Invisalign or anything like that. So my own son is a perfect example. If I showed you pictures of him when he was, six, seven, eight, you'd be like, oh, 100% he's gonna need braces. And you know what? We widened his jaws. He used some eruptive guidance appliances. And guess what? Everything came in pretty darn straight to the point where he's got like 1 millimeter of crowding on tooth number seven. And I notice it because I'm an orthodontist. I can see all these things. He doesn't care. No one else notices. People think he had braces, and he's pretty darn happy about it. And he has zero interest in treating that. So that's driftodontics. If you build it, they will go to the right place for the most part. Can't promise. And same thing can go even with adults. A lot of times that, if you either do a little IPR or, even perhaps there's a ton of lower crowding and they're all bunched up. Sometimes you just extract that central incisor, everything kind of lines up on its own. Believe it or not. Can't promise though, but just a little tip. So that's a term. Hopefully you'd understand the concept of drift and how you can use it favorably in orthodontics. All right, thanks so much.